If you're still here today, you're invested in your healing, and that's a great start, one that can only give you liberation. We have Help Library to thank for this meeting of minds. In each of us, there's a dull, ongoing ache within, pervading our consciousness, waking or otherwise. We cannot see this ache because the wound is very, very deep. And for some of us, the wound is so deep that we don't even recall ever having gotten this ache. It suits most of us to actually forget its existence because the pain of dealing with it now far outweighs the original pain. However, whatever is pushed out of sight grows in the darkness disproportionately. And then one day, out of the blue, you feel the heat because in your external world, something extremely challenging has happened and you find it next to impossible to deal with it. Your adult self lacks the resources to overcome the setback. There's an emergence of your inner child or one of your inner children. This one could be the inner child that did not learn how to navigate an emotional loss. Now, you have heard of this phrase inner child on this platform many times, presumably. It's that kind of a thing that all therapists want to add to their repertoire of healing skills because the need is so high for such kind of therapy or healing. So why am I discussing it here again? Well, I want to give you some ways or tools to work on your inner child yourself and firstly to understand it a little more than you already do. Or at least start the process. And if you get stuck, find a suitable therapeutic intervention to complete the process. Now, without really identifying it as such, we face our inner children every single day. Each time we are thwarted or rejected or feel abandoned or alone, our inner child calls out from within for our mercy, for us to integrate it back into our conscious acceptance. And the negative feelings that you avoid or you dislike or distance yourself from the most are all related to your inner children. For most people, it's daunting to allow the memories associated with inner children to surface. But if we have to release our hurt, our betrayal in relation to our childhood, but that which we are facing today as adults, we need the courage to face our neglected inner children. Let's start with figuring out what an inner child is. For every childhood experience you have ever had, whether constructive or adverse, you created an inner child. Sometimes a satisfied one, and at other times a greedy, needy, clinging one, the one that has unfulfilled needs. Now, only if you heal the latter, the needy child, can you come to a happy, accepting place of who you are today. Such negative or adverse childhood experiences, as they are usually called, can stay forever etched in our memory if we don't heal our inner children. This can have unhealthy implications on our mind and body, creating a host of chronic or psychosomatic illnesses. So what are adverse childhood experiences? There are many categories, and in all of which, all it takes is the destruction of the child's autonomy to feel and think independent of what the elders around it deem fit. So any kind of neglect and abuse can be part of this mix. The mind and the body of the child can suffer delayed or disrupted development, creating potential ill health for life. Now let's see how we turn out as adults when we've had adverse childhood experiences. How easy it is for us to criticize ourselves, isn't it very easy? When the inner critic faithfully points out to us how horrid, how fat, how stupid, how ugly, how useless, how unlovable we are. Do you not agree? Do remember the contrary is true as well. If you believe there is so much that's ugly in you, then if the duality concept of life is to be believed, then there's an equally potent mixture of the loving, the compassionate, the joyful, and the capable within you. Because of the brain's negative bias, it's easier to look at what is wrong with us it's far easier to see our blemishes and our weaknesses through other people's eyes, especially, for it confirms to us what we knew all along, that we're not good enough. And it'll take a concerted and consistent effort on our parts to look inside and find the golden boy or girl waiting to be discovered and embraced. This is called self-love. Going back again and again and again to yourself. Seeing the goodness in you. That's what in therapy we experience. That state of heart-centeredness where we see the gentler, softer, lovable parts of ourselves. We learn to be vulnerable, not hide behind a strong, invincible exterior. What you need to do is make a note of the messages you are sending yourself. You know what? There's a 24/7 constant internal WhatsApping happening from you to you and keeping you on the constant vigil so as not to let down your guard. You do not wish to be hurt. You do not wish to be betrayed. You do not want to be falsely loved yet again, like you may have been as a child. So you learn to safe wrap your heart in sealant, which not just keeps you from your positive feelings, but physiologically it shuts off blood supply to and fro. Do you comprehend the extensive hurt you can cause yourself? If the blood supply to the rest of your body is deficient for any reason, emotional or physiological or psychological, you're landing yourself in big, big trouble. So that was your adult self. Now let's go back to the inner child. Because I believe healing oneself at this level is necessary for us to mirror back to our adult self a healthy sense of belonging, trust, and wholeness. So nobody else, especially not your spouse and your children, are going to do you the favor of bolstering your false ego. Consistent wrong messages to yourself can cause a lot of harm. Having inner children running amok can have a debilitating effect on your immune system as well as your nervous system. Can your inner child be treated with cosmetics, with antibiotics, with surgery? No. Because all these interventions are superficial. The inner child wound is deep, it's hidden, and more often than not, out of conscious understanding. So what you don't know, how will anyone else help you with? It's not until you begin to suffer the consequences of neglecting your inner children and you get a mental or physical backlash, do you actually awaken to your childhood trauma. And the stress trapped within you from all those years ago cannot allow you to see yourself with eyes of kindness and love. And that stuck energy has to be released, either with inner child work in the capable hands of a practitioner who can be that kind, loving mirror to you, or by healing yourself with integrative approaches such as 1. Self-hypnosis. You can learn how to hypnotize yourself. Yoga, mindfulness, meditation, and a host of other approaches that focus on healing the heart. Now, your inner child thrives in a flowing heart, full of self-love. There's no better time than now to embrace and release that which you have locked away since childhood. You can begin with self-love. It's a technique that never ever fails. You may ask, how do I love myself? It's so much easier to love another person. One of the best ways is to heal your cellular biology. So I'm going to give you a technique because every experience affects each cell in your body and you have to work with all those millions of cells in your body for you to heal. One very simple everyday technique is of scanning the body internally, washing every cell in your body with a kind and love-filled gaze. With repetition and dedication, your insides will start mellowing and becoming softer. And the places that have hardened because of all the negative feedback you have got, or either from yourself or from others, all that begins to melt away. And very soon you begin to feel a lightness, an essential goodness that starts to flood your cells with a different kind of energy. This is how you start loving yourself inside out, rather than outside in, which you have been doing with shopping and eating and shopping and trying to find love on the outside. So today, let us end here with a silent promise to ourselves that we will look inside and send love down there to every living cell, again and again and again. And we repeat this every single day and every moment of our life. Every single day, remember. It's lovely talking to you. Bye. I will see you tomorrow.